Hey everyone, this is Dan, and I'm going to record my screen and show you how to create an instructional video with a screen recording. So, as you can see, I'm using Camtasia, and the other app I'm going to record off of is Microsoft Word. The idea behind this sample project is I have a process in Microsoft Word that I want to share with other people, so I'm going to record myself going through all those steps. And a screen recording is a fantastic way to share that information. So I do have a script and an outline that I've kind of prepared for myself. So I'm going to start going through it right now that I have Word ready to go. So what I'm going to do is start recording in Camtasia. Open the recording. And we're going to choose this Rode Podcaster microphone. You can see that when I speak, it detects it. I'm also going to choose this full screen here, which is my second screen. Now you can see that it shows up, it shows Word, so that confirms when I'm recording. That's all I'm going to use at the moment. I'm going to hit start recording, and it counts down. All right, and so we're now recording. You can see up here with the red indicator that we are recording. And even though I'm talking right now, I can easily cut this out once I start editing. So I'm going to begin now. Welcome to this quick tip on how to customize the quick access toolbar in Microsoft Word. Keep in mind this tutorial is for the Mac version of Word. The PC version is slightly different. Okay, so that's the end of my recording. I'm going to go up now to stop recording. And when I do that, Camtasia loads up and it puts my screen recording with my narration onto the first track of the project. This Zoom feature is a very helpful way to kind of navigate through your project, especially for longer projects. You can zoom in by going towards the plus, or you can just click on plus, click on minus to zoom out and see more of the project. But what I'll do is I'll go towards the beginning and zoom in, scroll over, and now I can see this is the beginning part where I was kind of talking about, well, now I'm going to record and let's begin. But I don't need everything over here. So I'm going to just pick a spot right here, give myself some space. That's about a second of space right there before I start talking. And I'm going to add a cut right there. It's called split in Camtasia. It's an easy way to add cuts into your project. And so now you see that if I move over here, there's a cut right there. What I could do is just select this and hit the delete button, and that gets rid of it. But now I've got this big space, empty space at the beginning of the project. And if I were to export this video, it would begin at zero, and it would play, and we'd have roughly 15 seconds of just nothing until the project actually begins. So I'm going to hit undo, Control-Z or Command-Z. Instead of just clicking delete there, I'm going to right-click, and I'm going to use this feature called ripple delete. And when you ripple delete something, it means that it will take this out and move the entire project, it will move it back to fill up the space. So there will be no blank space in the project, which is something, like I said, you definitely don't want. So watch what happens. Ripple delete, boop. This whole thing shifted to the left, and now there's no empty space, and the project will begin. So now that I've got my project here, I'm ready to start editing. I've got this beginning part where I'm giving an introduction, and I would like to do something at the beginning to let people know what this video is about. So I'd like to put a really simple title here. And so if you'd like to add text to your project to put on top of video, you can go to this annotations bar and you can add, just click and drag this in. Now it's going to look like there's nothing here because the text at the moment is in white, so it really blends into the background. But one thing you'll notice is that as I'm dragging around, you see those lines occasionally pop up, and those are guides to help you center whatever you're adding to the screen. So you can see I've got a vertical line and a horizontal line. That means I'm dead center in the middle. So I'm just going to release. Now you can see that it's added what is called a callout piece of text to the screen. And once again, you can't see it because it's white on white. What I'll do is I'll go over here to the color picker and I'll just change it to black and make it very obvious that this is where it is. Now to edit it, you just simply double click it on the text, and I'm just going to start typing how to use the quick access toolbar, and I'm going to hit enter a couple times and say Microsoft Word. All right, so that is very small. I'm going to make that bigger. One of the ways you can make it bigger is you have a lot of the usual formatting options. I'm going to make it bold. I'm going to increase the size. I'm going to click and drag this here. I'm fine with that, but maybe there's a specific font size. I want a 96 because that's a specific size that is important to me. How to use the quick access toolbar, Microsoft Word. All right, that's great. So when it starts playing, the text will immediately be there. And then around 5 seconds in, actually exactly 5 seconds in, it will just pop out like that. And that's okay, but maybe I want something a little more elegant. When the text goes away, I can add a transition. A transition is basically an animated effect that takes you from one piece of video to another, or one shape to another. It adds a nice little design, but there are many, many different ones to choose from, and I encourage you to try them out. Some are pretty crazy, some are very subtle. There's all kinds you can use. You can add these arrow slices if you want. I'm going to just click and drag it down to the end, and you can see this is what it will look like, the arrow slice, and now the text has gone away. All right, so that's pretty dramatic. I don't want that. I'm going to click on that. It's now selected, and I'm going to hit the delete key, and that goes away. There are many transitions that you can choose from. I tend to go with something pretty simple, which is the fade, and you can see it's one of my favorites because I clicked on it and start it. So now when I go to my favorites up here in Camtasia, it's one of my favorite elements that I like to add, transitions and behaviors and things. I'm just gonna drag this down. Now you can see it's a very gentle fade from the text, and now it shows the video full screen. And I'm gonna just stick with that. So what happens next in this tutorial is I'm talking about the quick access toolbar, and I let people know that it is up here on this blue bar. You can see as I'm shuttling back and forth, I'm referring to it up there. So what I would like to do is I would like to draw people's attention to that quick access toolbar. There's a couple different ways you could do it. You could use an arrow, you could draw a shape, you could highlight just that part and fade everything else out. You could even zoom in to that space. And I think I'm going to do that. In fact, I might do a couple of those things. I would like to, when my mouse goes up there, I would like to zoom in so we see this area of Microsoft Word a bit better. What I'm going to do here is click on the video clip, and I'm going to go to animations, and we'll use this scale up feature. And we're going to add it right there. You see it adds it to a specific spot. There are two circles here. This is where it starts, and this is where the animation ends. So you can see that when I added it, it's just zooming into the middle because I haven't really told it where I want to scale up to. I'm going to click on that second dot. I'm going to grab this by the center X here, and I can move it around. All right, so I'm taking the piece of video and I'm moving it around the canvas. What I'd like to do is make it so that we see this a little better. So I've just kind of taken it and shifted it down a little bit. So now, when we go through, you can see the scale up kind of zooms in to this upper left corner. So that's one way to draw the eye to a specific element on the screen. Another way is to draw a shape. And I'm going to go back to annotations and go to this squiggly line menu. And you can see that there are these animated shapes that you can add to your project. I'm going to use this square one. I'm going to drag it onto the screen. I'm going to put it around the quick access toolbar, but you can see as a square, it doesn't really fit. What you can do is resize it, but you can see it remains as a square. If you just grab one of the circles on the side, the resizing circles, it just keeps it as a square. What I need to do is hold down the shift key, which I'm doing right now, and grab one of those resize circles, and you see now it just brings in the shape and reforms it the way I want. So I'm going to keep holding shift and bring this up. Almost got it. I'm going to keep holding shift again, and I think that right there is a good size. The yellow is okay. I would like this to be bigger though. Like, I want the rectangle to be thicker. So what we can do is click on that element in the timeline, or you can just click on it here. You see it's now selected. And over in the properties menu, we'll click on that. It's called a sketch motion shape. And now we can adjust the thickness. So as I drag this to change the thickness, you can watch it on screen. You see the yellow is getting thicker. Like, this is way too big. Now it's covering everything. But I think about 8 would be good. So what does this actually look like, this special sketch motion thing? Well, here we go. That's what it looks like. So I actually have those two things on top of each other. I have the scale up, so we're kind of zooming in, and then the sketch motion jumps in there and draws your eye to the quick access toolbar. I think I just want to move the sketch motion until after the zoom in is done, so it's not too hectic looking. So let's do this. We'll zoom in, and then it does that, and I'm happy with that. So one thing I've noticed as I've been editing my project, I found this segment here where I was talking about a feature and I realized I made a mistake. So I want to get rid of this, and I want to show you something. You notice that on this playhead, there's a green and red little tip on each side there. What you can do is use those to select portions of the timeline and easily remove them. So let me just show you how that works real quick. I'm going to position the playhead at the beginning of the spot where I want to edit, and that's right here. Then I'm going to drag the red tab to the end of the spot that I want to get rid of. So now this portion here is stuff I want to get out of the project. Now what I'm going to do here is I'm going to do a ripple delete range. It will ripple delete the range that is defined by the green and red tabs. And watch what happens when I do that. You can see now there is a stitch in this video, and it has removed the unwanted part of the video, and it's closed in, so there's no empty space. I love using the ripple delete feature because it makes editing so much easier, and you can go through a project very quickly, get rid of any mistakes, any bad takes, and you get your project done much more quickly. So I'm here at the end of my project. I've finished going through and editing this, and I'm happy with all the cuts I've made and different elements I've added. So I'm ready to share this with the world. So what you do is go up to export, and you're going to export it as a local file. And this is where you give it a name and you say, this is cat demo final, or call it whatever you like. And if you export it as an MP4, that's the most compatible video format that there is. And when you hit export, it will begin exporting the video file. Depending on how long your video project is. This could take quite long. If you add lots of animations and on-screen elements, it could take quite long. So do be patient. But when it's done, you'll have a video that you can share with your team, share with your audience. You can post it on your website. You can put it on YouTube, put it in your e-learning course. All kinds of options are available for you to share this information. So I hope this has been helpful, and good luck to you creating your instructional videos. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, click the subscribe button and visit GoSkills.com/LMS to get our free learning management system, which makes it easy for you to train your team online.